G'day and welcome back to Buildsum, and this is the ninth and the last video in calculating wall bracing. And this one we're just going to look at the connection of the bracing, because it's no good designing all this bracing and then not connecting it to the floor or not connecting it to the ceiling properly. So the timber framing code, paragraph 8.3.6.9, talks about fixing to the top of bracing walls. So it says that all internal bracing walls shall be fixed to the floor or the lower story bracing walls, the ceiling or the roof frame, and or the external wall frame with structural connections of equivalent shear capacity to the bracing capacity of that particular wall bracing. Nominal and other bracing walls with bracing capacity up to 1.5 kilonewtons per meter only require nominal fixing, so you don't have to put any extra fixing in. So table 8.22, that table outlines the requirements for bracing walls to ceiling connection. Okay, so here's a bit of a look at the table. This is just two of the connections. There are quite a few in there. So connection type A, it talks about the actual number of nails, types of nails, size of the actual timber, the number of nails or screws that you need to put the trimmer in, and then the number of nails or screws that you actually need to put into the top of the wall. And there's a note there, those if you're using a truss roof, those holes actually have to be bigger than the screw, so the screw or the timber can move up and down on the screw to allow for deflection in the trusses. All right, so that's that one there. Type B, okay, slightly different. Okay, so the timber framing code gives you all these requirements. So you have to match your connection type to your ceiling to the bracing capacity of the actual wall, okay? So that's for the top of the wall. For fixing to the floor, the timber framing code says that the bottom plate of a timber framed bracing wall shall be fixed at the ends of the bracing panel and, if required, immediately to the floor frame or concrete slab with connections determined in table 8.18, which goes up to 3.4 kilonewtons per meter. And otherwise, you have to look at table 8.23 and table 8.24. Okay, and they're also generally covered off in the table that tells you about the bracing units themselves. Okay, so just remember you need to design your connection to suit your bracing sheets as well. And there you go, that's the end of the series on designing wind bracing. I hope that helps.
G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.